challenging times for Macedonia. Regrettably, I'm unable to present this conference. Nevertheless, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate the United Macedonian Diaspora for the organization of this conference and wish them great success in their future work. The Republic of Macedonia is proud of the diaspora, American, Canadian, and Australian Macedonians, as well as the Macedonians living throughout Europe, and are the most important links between their old country and their new homeland. The fact that Washington, D.C. was chosen as the venue of the first UND Global Conference is of great significance. The United States of America is a strategic ally of the Republic of Macedonia. Our partnership has deep roots, and generations of leaders in politics, civil society, the arts services, both men and women, have made an invaluable contribution towards this. Many of these people are here in Washington today. I would especially like to thank Senator Rachel Lugar, Congresswoman Candace Miller, Congressman Harry Mitchell, Congressman Bill Pascrell, Congressman Earl Pomeroy, Congressman Mark Sauder, Major General Dewey, Ambassador Philip Reaver, and the many other men and women for their hard work in bringing our two nations closer together in the aim to achieve victory for the ideals we share. Our two nations strive for the ideals of freedom, democracy, rule of law, and the respect of diversity. It is for these ideals that our men and women in uniform stand shoulder to shoulder with men and women in uniform in the United States and other allies, whether that may be in the deserts of Iraq or the mountains of Afghanistan. For 18 years, the Republic of Macedonia has been living in a dream of a free, independent, and democratic state. Macedonia today is a shining example of an open and multicultural society. It has courageously faced the challenges of the Balkan past, creating its own functional model, which unites its citizens and ensures a common and prosperous future. The Republic of Macedonia has remained faithful to its noble traditions. These traditions and values shared by all citizens of Macedonia, regardless of their ethnic or religious background. These traditions of togetherness, mutual respect, and respect for the rights and freedoms of others form the foundation of all documents on Macedonian statehood. Hence, the unity and vitality of Macedonian society do not rely on the rule of the majority, but rather on the participation of all communities and of all citizens in the functioning of the state and in the development of society. The Republic of Macedonia has a clear strategic agenda. We strive to see Macedonia as a member of NATO and the European Union, a country which is strong and respected, with proud, prosperous and happy citizens. In attaining these goals, the Republic of Macedonia continues to preserve resolutely on the path open to Euro-Atlantic integration and to pursue a responsible domestic and foreign policy. Our country is faced with a large challenge. Its goal of Euro-Atlantic integration is challenged by an irrational problem imposed by a single member state of NATO and the European Union. We are encouraged by the support of the United States of America, Canada, and many other nations in discussions on overcoming this problem that continue under the auspices of the United Nations. I am personally grateful to the Macedonian diaspora and to organizations such as the United Macedonian Diaspora for being ambassadors for their homeland, Macedonia. Therefore, the Macedonian people call upon you, dear friends, to continue and intensify your efforts for spreading the truth and fighting for a more just world, a world in which all people will have the right to freely express their name, identity, language, and culture, wherever they live. As the great Martin Luther King Jr. once said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. My God bless you. Dr. Jordi Ivanov, President of the Republic of Macedonia.